Hey guys, just want to make this really quick video. As you know, the world has gone kind of crazy about the COVID-19 virus. Here in Australia, we're starting to actually get panic buying, and there's a lot of talk about lockdown. I'm not going to, in this video, tell you to wash your hands or stay away from people. There's enough people talking about that, and I feel a lot of misinformation. Don't be drinking bleach. Don't be doing any of these kind of crazy things. If you didn't do it before COVID-19, it's a really good idea not to. But I wanted to share with you something that I learned about just recently that allows you to help out with the research and hopefully a cure or at least an inoculation against COVID-19. Standford University has an incredible research group where they take proteins and they fold them. And what's really important about this is that there's no microscope in the world that allow you to shrink down to the size of a protein. So what they do is by folding these proteins in simulation, and these are computer simulations, they're able to actually explore what a protein does. And ultimately, viruses are made up of a whole lot of different proteins. They're running a project since 2000 called Folding at Home. And what this project is all about is using your computer to share some of that data, do some of the processing, and then upload the answer to Standford University, and that information is then shared. Why is this kind of important? Well, if you wanted to fold one protein on your home computer and you had a great gaming machine or the most powerful MacBook Pro, it would take about 500 years to fold that protein all at once and actually get an answer. And you can see that's not going to help anyone. So even though they've got supercomputers, what they've actually put into place is a piece of software that allows them to break down that folding process and share it around to everyone. So what's that mean for you? Well, it's really simple. You will allow your computer when you're not using it. So if you leave it on or if you're working, you can actually define in the program when you're not using it to then take that time and that processing power and apply it to that problem. And by doing that, they kind of build a virtual supercomputer by using everyone's machines. I think this is a wonderful idea. Right now, they have openly shared the problem of COVID-19 and are sharing the answers to scientists all over the world. This is something that you can do. And this is something that you can do that doesn't take a lot of effort. You don't have to go to the stores and fight groups. You don't have to have the answer yourself. But if you have a computer, and most people do, you are able to download this piece of software, place it on your computer, and actually share the processing time. Now, they're not just dealing with COVID-19. They deal with cancer and different diseases all around the world. But right now, we are really struggling to find an answer of basically a pandemic that's affecting everyone in the world. I believe in this project, and I believe that if everyone was to share their computing time right now, it would bring us that much closer to having an answer. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put links below, and they're gonna send you to not only the download page, but I'm also gonna send you to the main page so you can go look at it yourself. I know there's a little bit of fear right now about like putting programs on your computer because maybe people can get into it and hack your money and all that sort of stuff. That's not what this is. If you feel comfortable about it, I strongly suggest downloading this program and letting it run. Maybe leave your computer on at night, or if you're working from home like I am, being able to let your computer do this processing when you have lunch or you have downtime or you're on the phone. This is something that we can all do. It's not about everyone else doing the work for us. I feel strongly that there is a big lessons to come out of this COVID-19 pandemic. I think this is an incredible opportunity for all of us to pull together because we are always stronger together than we are apart. And I think that, you know, as a maker, people keep saying to me, what are you going to come up with that's going to help answer the problem? And I think this is one that I don't have to make, but I would love to be able to share it with you. Guys, stay safe. I said I was going to say it, but wash your hands. And you know what? This is going to be a real challenge for the next couple of weeks and months. But I believe we'll all come out of this healthy, having learnt something. I think that's really important and kind of lacking, and that's a little bit of love to everyone's neighbors. That's why I love the maker movement, because it really does instill a sharing and a standing by each other. I think that's kind of been lost in the wider world. So, you know, let's be examples. If you know people who have computers that are sitting there or just on, please speak to them about putting this folding software, folding at home, on their machines, or maybe you can do it themselves, or send them to this channel. I'm not gonna even ask you guys to subscribe this time. This is not what this is about. If you have any recommendations on other things that you think that people can use to help during this time, please let us know in the links below, and I will do my best to send that out as much as I can. Please stay safe, you know, spend time with your family, stay indoors, and we'll see you at the end of all of this. Take care.